This is Alex Reynolds, and you're watching Nerd Something or Other. Today we're talking about first impressions on the Surface Go. So yeah, let's get into that. So Surface Go, basically, well, we've got a lot of different Surface products, right? Surface Pros and Studios and Books and I don't even remember what they call the laptop thing. Surface Go kind of falls into, they're trying to make a Surface Pro that's really more affordable, more of a an iPad competitor kind of a thing, right? So this thing's going, I think the Surface Pro starts at like $800 without keyboard or pen. But this thing starts at $400 without keyboard or pen. But it does work with a keyboard and the pen. So that's really cool. That's what really gets me excited. I love seeing stuff that works with a pen, especially in a tablet form. It can be used as a sketch pad, right? There's like that laptop that I can't remember the name of. That, what was it? It can be used with a pen, but I don't know. What are you going to do with a pen on a laptop? It's kind of weird, but... let's see, back to the Surface Go. A lot of people out here today. So I guess I'm really excited because it's a low price Surface Pro, kind of. You know, lower power processor as you would expect. Lower RAM as you would expect. But still pretty good stuff, pretty solid numbers. 4 8 gigs of RAM, like an i3 kind of processor from what I've heard. Not an i3, but I'm not used to this vlogging on the street thing. This is weird. I gotta get used to these people. But I think it's gonna be pretty powerful, really. I mean, it's for its price, I think it's a really good tablet, a really good laptop. You know, emotionally, I'm pretty excited about it. Although I'm also kind of nervous about it too, which is dumb. But I just feel like I've seen this before, right? They've done the Surface 3. The Surface originally was really just, it's a bad idea, right? You know, being stuck with a Windows 10 store when it just came out and it didn't have any apps yet. Surface 3, I thought they really nailed it. It was thin, it was light, great kickstand, good power. You could use it with the Windows 10 store, or you could use it with, downloadable Windows 10 apps or whatever, you know, install whatever you want on it. You know, lower power, but it ran like a real Windows 10 PC. So I thought that was good. I was kind of surprised that that washed out into obscurity. I'm curious what makes this stand out as better than that. I really don't know if there's any big differences between that one and this one, other than, you know, it's newer with newer processors and RAM. I'm excited they got the USB-C port on there. I don't really know why, but I'm excited about that. I don't know, it just seems like a fun little tablet. I feel like I'm probably not going to end up getting one. You know, I want to use it for sketching and all that kind of thing. And the way I use my Surface Pro at home and the Surface Book at work, I have a tendency to push those to their limits already because I use such high-resolution images and so many layers. They kind of jam up a little bit as is. I can't imagine trying to do it on a less powerful device. I don't think it'd go so well for me. But again, for more casual jars that aren't doing such high resolution stuff, doing more regular resolution things and a handful of layers, I think it's going to be great. And it should be great for surfing the web and stuff like that too, right? But then, I don't know, like, where does this tablet fit into the market, right? Is it competing against iPads? Is it competing against Chromebooks? What's it going after? I feel like it's going after both of those. But maybe not effectively on either side, right? I think it's going for the school market too. But like, think about this, for iPads, I think this could be a great iPad replacement, but let's be honest, iOS is simpler and easier to use than Windows 10 is. Windows 10 has come a long way and it is great. I love it. But for the masses, iOS is so easy and everybody knows how to use it already. Like my parents' generation, they're all using that stuff and they're very comfortable with it. And I don't think Windows 10 can really compete on that level of ease of use. Going after Chromebooks, I think the problem is going to be price. Chromebooks, you can get them so cheap. This $400 price tag is great, but it's not really going to compete with the prices on Chromebooks, especially in the school market. I think that's going to run into stuff. When people are buying computers for themselves, I think that could work out because it's a premium laptop. It's really cool. People will do that. But when you're talking about schools buying stuff in mass, they want effective and they need cheap because they don't have much funding, right? And they're selling a premium device here. You can get Chromebooks that are just as effective for a way lower price. So that's going to make a lot more sense for schools than this thing. So I don't know. I'm excited about it. I think it's really cool. I'm curious how it fits in the market and how it's any different from the Surface 3 and how it's going to outlast, how long the Surface 3 lasted. Very curious to see how this plays out. But I think it's really cool. I hope it does well. I don't know. What do you all think? Tell me in the comments below. Do you guys think this one's going to survive better than the Surface and the Surface 3 did? Do you think this can outdo an iPad? Do you think it can become an essential for schools? Is there something I'm missing here? Is there a niche market? Is there some sort of market here that I'm missing that it's going to do really well in? What do you all think? Y'all let me know. Hit up the comments below. Be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button. And that's the Surface Go and my thoughts on it. Have a good one. I'll see y'all on the next one. Bye.